Jurgen Klopp is right. English football is driving our best young talents to the knacker's yard. The likes of Sturridge, Wilshere and Walcott all seem permanently crocked after breaking through at a young age, and no other country seems to suffer quite like we do. No other nationality debunks the hype surrounding English football better than the Germans. Take Didi Hamann being asked for his memories of Sven's men thrashing Germany 5-1 in Munich, for a 10th anniversary TV special. Well, it was a World Cup qualifier, both countries qualified, Germany made it to the final, but I can't remember how early England went out. Or this put down, a few years back, from comic Henning Wehn to a heckler who'd yelled 2 World Wars and 1 World Cup at him, 3 World Cups and 1 World Pope. And, despite only working here a month, Jurgen Klopp has already exposed 2 inconvenient truths about a game: that young English players are having the fitness drained from their bodies, and the money men's quest to turn our once atmospheric stadiums into profit factories has sucked the life out of them. Behind the happier hipster is a hard man who speaks his mind, and we are well to listen. Last month, when Jordan Rusiter returned from England under 19 duty with a hamstring injury, Klopp angrily warned the FA, "I have never heard of a player that young playing 3 games in 5 days. If we handle them like horses, then we get horses." An observation backed up by the fact that 37 of the 142 English players in the Premier League are currently injured. No other country suffers anywhere near that scale of problem. Why? Damien Comolli, who has worked as technical director here and abroad, believes these problems stem back to what happens to a player between the ages of 10 and 19. Indeed, looking at the likes of Daniel Sturridge, Jack Wilshere and Theo Walcott, who broke through for club and country at an early age, and now seem permanently crocked, Klopp is right to ask why we're driving our best young talents into the knacker's yard. Just as he was right to point out to those Liverpool fans who walked out in the 82nd minute of the home defeat to Crystal Palace, that this wasn't the attitude he was used to in Germany. And certainly not how he imagined the fabled Anfield atmosphere to be. Where, he implied, is this famous 12th man I've heard so much about? It's a question many away fans who aren't there for a big European or Premier League game have been asking for years. Anfield's not alone. When the Tories have finished their savage cuts, Premier League grounds will be the only libraries we have left. The reasons are many. When terraces existed and tickets were cheap, grounds were full of young, working class locals who felt they were part of the entertainment. Today, due to the most prohibitive ticket prices in world football, the average home fan is mid-40s and relatively well off, with plenty there as part of a tourist package trip. They see themselves as consumers with choice rather than fanatics with no other choice than devoting themselves to a cause that's in their blood. That's why when supporters groups argue that football without fans is nothing, they're not trying to blag cheap tickets, they're pointing out the truth that fan exploitation has gone too far. That the criteria for entering a ground should not just be about the size of your wallet but the depth of your love for the club. That hardcore fans should be viewed as vital assets, not undesirable revenue streams who fail your credit check. Something has gone seriously wrong when you find a better atmosphere watching the game in the 12th man pub a stone's throw from Anfield than inside what used to be England's most passionate stadium, where the 12th man used to help win matches. Dank, Jurgen. If your astute words about your adopted club and country stir much needed debates, you'll have done them both a huge favor.